Second Chronicles chapter 7 and verse 14. My Bible is on page 264. Sorry. Listen, this is the word of God. That if my people who are called by name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and restore their land. Amen. Listen up again. Listen up. Don't talk, don't do anything, but just listen to the word of God. 전도사님. 김전도사님, can you do it later? Then if my people who are called by my name, God's name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, and I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and restore their land. Amen. Thank you, man. Can you put out the smoke and can you sit down? Okay. This is a story that I want to share with you. One particular Sunday, a preacher was preaching a powerful sermon on hell and how terrible hell would be. In the congregation, there was one fellow who fell asleep every Sunday. The preacher came to a point where he pounded the pulpit to emphasize how bad the hell was. I said, if anyone wants to go to hell, let him stand up right now. Well, the only part that the sleeping guy heard was the stand up right now part. And so he did it. He stood there for a few moments and looked around, then he said, well, preacher, I don't know what we just bore on, but it looks like you and me are the only ones for it. It's a good joke. Don't fall asleep, okay? You may miss the great days. You like it? Oh, okay. A lot of folks understand English, right? Solomon, the greatest, the wisest king, the wisest man, wealthiest man, richest man, that is King Solomon. King Solomon gave 1,000 times of the burnt offering to the Lord, and God appealed to him in his dream. God was so pleased, happy. And it, when I read this, you know, particular passage, God was so excited, you know, and he showed up in his dream that, Solomon, what do you want me to do? It sounds like, whatever you like to do, you want me to do, I will do it for you. Eh? What does that mean? The 1,000 times of burnt offering. 1,000 times of burnt offering. You are worshiping here, sitting here, and enjoying the shade. And sit down. Whenever the food truck comes, you just run it there and come back and enjoy it in a time and sitting. This is worshiping. This is offering. What is the offering? Burnt offering to the God in Old Testament times? It's not a lay back and enjoying something like that. They have to get the goats and the lambs and the worms, and they clean up, kill them, clean up, and cut it in half, and they shed the blood, and they put it on the altar to the Lord. What are so many things to do to worship and give offering to the Lord in Old Testament times? Solomon didn't mind whatever it takes to please God, I will do it. So he did a maximum times of doing worshiping him. even that. Sitting here 1 hour, boring, when you gonna give me food? When I gonna take the easy way? But Solomon cut the, catch the cows, catch the lambs and, and cut it off and clean it up and get the, all the, the blood out and spread it. Lord, this is my blood. This is my people's blood. Please forgive our people's sins. That is worshiping. I want you to remember, I come out here just maybe 2 hours or 3 hours. But you know what? You guys just sitting here about maybe hour and 2 hours. Now, all the folks here, me, myself, in order for preparing this worship, I have to call, I have to prepare. What should I bring? What should I do? What should I do? You know, pray for you. And I'm not bragging this, but I'm preparing a whole week for coming out to see you and bring you guys into the presence of the Lord to receive the most precious blessing that we cannot see it. We cannot feel it. But God is doing it. That's my purpose, the sole purpose. And these people, purpose to come out to bring you into the presence of the Lord. That is this, purpose and design for doing this, worshiping Lord. John chapter 4:23, God is, God seeks whosoever worship Him and please Him and honor Him. Amen? The worship is the most precious thing that we can do. What is the worship? You just sit there. But you just open your heart and give your love and honor, your supplication, your crying out. Something that you want to talk to Him, you can do it. That is worship. Amen. Amen. And then God was very pleased that, hey Solomon, let me give you the secret way of restoring the people's life, the way of restoring and transforming the lives of the people. This is the word that Solomon get scripture in the living word of God from God. So it says, 7:14 says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sins, will heal the land. A lot of people try hard, I know you try hard to get out of this kind of situation. I don't doubt you do your best to try to make your life straight, trying to get out of the homelessness, trying to get out of the jobless, trying to put together your family in unity. I don't doubt that you do best. But you know what? Sometimes you give up before you reach the last minute. Do you understand what I'm saying? You're almost there, but you give up. You can do. I think this is the way to reach the final point, the final, the last line. This is simple. I don't have to explain this to you, but listen up. Then do it. Then you will be there. And God will be there. Ask them anybody who works in that gorgeous building, who lives in the mountain, great place, whosoever found Jesus in their lives, ask them how they found they found it, how their life been straightened by. Just a simple things. This is a formula. Do not doubt it. Take it and try it. Amen?
Amen.
The simple way, let me read it to you again. If my people who are called by name, called by my name is what? Like a little child. When a little child needed help, who called? Who the child called? Mommy, right? Mommy. Mommy, I need you. I want you. Mommy, I love you. Come, I need your help. If my people call by my name, that means, Lord, I need your help. Trusting Him is the only one who can help you. Amen?
Amen.
You know that when somebody got an emergency case situation, who do they call? Who's going to come and help you? 911, right? Why you call the 911? Because 911 definitely will come and help you, right? Amen. The call upon the Lord means you trust Him. He is the only one that He can help you and serve you and make you straight for your life. Amen?
Amen.
But trust Him. And call Him. And call Him. Don't call somebody else. Don't call somebody else. Don't call me, you know. I'm tired of sometimes, you know. But God is not tired of you. Amen.
Amen.
Call God. Call God. Trust Him and call God. He's the ultimate helper. I would just be your friend. But He is ultimate. Helper. Call Him. Call Him. Secondly, what? Pray and seek my face. Pray and seek my face. Pray and seek my face. You know what? You're sitting down there. Don't look for the food truck. Don't look for something else. But look for the face of the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Look for the face of the Lord. Look for the face of the Lord. If you don't look for Him, you never see it. I look for Him. I really wanted to feel it. And sometimes, you know what? I'm burnt out. Sometimes I feel really down. So what did I do? I kneel down. Lord, help me. I need your strength. I need your love. I need your support. I don't want to say this, but bragging way, but I have so many supernatural experiences that it's really, put me on a high. So many visions that I can tell I see God. When you look for face of the Lord, then you will see Him. And more than you can see Him, more than you can see Him. Amen?
Amen.
Don't ever stop looking for His face. And turn from their wicked ways. Turn from their wicked ways. What is the wicked ways? You do drugs, and people do drugs and do the horrible things. Only that's the wicked way? No. That's the part of the wicked ways. What is the wicked ways? That means you put something else than God. It's the first wicked things in your life. Amen?
Amen.
Don't just look at the drugs why people ended up in doing drugs and doing something stupid things? Because their heart is in their heart something else is placed in the God. Amen.
Amen.
We have to put God before anything. Straighten up. We cannot get through our habitual sins away by our own strength and own power. Do you believe that? Do you agree with me? Am I right? What you do? Put God in the first place. Lord, I invite you. Take my life as, control my life. Control my life, I cannot tell you. Put the Lord in the first place means you stop doing drugs or stop doing stupid things and I'm not doing it, I'll stand before God. No, you're not, impossible. But put God in the first place. first place, Lord. Lord, please come into my place. Be Lord and Master of my life. The first thing. That's the most wicked things that people can do is put God in the second place. That's why what happens, a lot of people, you know, living in a good, wealthy and condition, they don't have joy, they don't have satisfaction, they don't have contentment. I met so many people in the higher rank and lower rank, and homeless and living. They have a emptiness in their heart because why? They don't put God in the first place. So please, don't think the weak way it is to doing something stupid things. The most stupid things, wicked things, is put in God's second place. Put God in the first place. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord, eh? Praise the Lord. Yes, yes. But lastly, what? Lastly. And then, repent, confess, and baptize. That's the, you know, way of the getting away from wickedness. But then it says, then I will hear from heaven. You know, it is conditional, right? God is what? Unconditional, but this, the passage tells the conditional. But you know what? This is a special occasion. Then I will hear from heaven, will forgive their sin, and will heal the land. Land is, means what? Means everything. Life, business, possessions, everything that you have will be restored. Praise the Lord. Amen? Don't try to do hard, okay? Don't try to do hard on quitting doing wrong stuff, quitting doing stupid things. But you know what? Just kneel down, eh? And ask Him to come into your heart and be my Lord and Savior. Control my life. Amen? Thanks. And God bless you. And